Your speaker today is Holmes Mogeri, a friend and colleague of mine for 16 years now. When I first met him, his door panel assembly line was already, in Toyota's eye, a showcase of lean, and it has gone through many iterations of improvements since. It has been running so well, in fact, that Holmes was able to take some time off to work with me on projects, and this led me to appreciate his unique blend of technical knowledge and ability to work with shop floor teams. During the last 13 months of his tenure on that production line, he has achieved extraordinary performance in quality, and he's about to tell you how. Hormoz?
Thank you, Michel, and good day, everyone. The main reason we are here today is to discuss some intricacies about achieving Beyond Six Sigma. And the reason we called it Beyond Six Sigma is because we were able to produce more than 1 million parts in a period of 13 months with zero defects to the customer. And that's something that we had never done before and is very unique to be able to produce 1 million parts over a year and a month with zero defects. But I want to discuss with you some of the things that we have done to come up with this extraordinary performance. As you see, the case study is called Out of the Doghouse, and the doghouse is the part that we assemble retainer to make it possible for us to assemble the door panel through the sheet metal, and it's called a doghouse. And that one was the problem for a problem-solving activity that we did. Just to give you an overview about the parts that we produce in this plant in Northern California, we were producing three different vehicles, manufactured and assembled, more than 1,000 different part numbers and colors and options, and over 1,700 vehicles per day was the production. Mainly plastic parts, all the interior plastic parts for two passenger cars and one truck for Toyota. The supply chain, as far as the process flow, you can see that from injection molding department, the section one, 16 times a day, our trucks would go to the paint line. The parts were being painted, and then 16 times a day, truck will take them to the assembly department, and shipping department was right next to it, and the parts were shipped to the customer at the rate of 10 times per day for door panels that they were built in sequence, and 23 times per day for any other non-door panel parts. And the customer was about 15 miles away from our plant. And when I say the door panels were built in sequence, I basically mean that based on the EDI, the electronic signal that we will receive from our customer at the rate of the tact time, which happened to be 53 seconds, we were able to produce the door panel, the right door panel for the vehicle that they would build it, and we would send it over there for 175 minutes later, so it would be assembled onto the vehicle that they had. So we had less than 3 hours to select parts, assemble, inspect, pack, ship, before we ship, load onto the truck, ship 15 miles, unload, unpack, present it to the assembly line at the parent company, and then assemble onto a vehicle. So really didn't have any room for errors or quality issues or mismatch or what have you. So you can appreciate producing more than 1 million parts in this kind of setting is a lot different from pulling from the inventory when you have the flexibility to throw away one part and get another one if the part happens to be defective. Then, as far as the our customers, we had three other customers other than NUMMI, which was in Fremont, California, and they were all in North America. Our motto was to dazzle the customer. You notice that we used the word dazzle, which is not a manufacturing word. We didn't say compliance with a specification, because this makes more sense to the team members and also to the customer. Customer wants to be surprised by the quality, cost, delivery, and all aspects of manufacturing. Therefore, we had only one job description for all the team members within our plant, and it was a very simple job description. We didn't have volumes upon volumes of how to do the work, but job description was that your job is to do whatever it takes to get the job done. Simple enough for everyone to understand, and also comprehensive for people to be able to follow and do. One local customer and four major customers in Northern California, in Northern North America. To give you an idea about door trim performance, door trim department performance, in the area of production efficiency, you see that we were at 100%. As far as warranty return, we had zero. This is in a period of 1 year. As far as KPM, Kanban per million delivery being late, we had zero. It was 100% on time. But in the area of quality, we had some issues. In the beginning of the year 2009, 35 pieces of door panels were found defective in the customer's plant, which raised our DPPM to 735. Now, you may say that compared to 2008, which was a 1943 DPPM, we looked good. But remember, that was the first month, and within the first week of the first month, we received this 735 DPPM, which was not good news and not the way to start the year. Our goal was 15 DPPM, which is a world-class quality, and this is the area of the gap that we had to fix with good quality so we will reach the goal. So we had a very daunting situation. In the beginning of the year, it was very depressing to have 735 DPPM as a result of one problem and 35 pieces. But nevertheless, we had to get to work and find out exactly what we needed to do to fix this issue. A little bit about the problem. We received a report from the customer that excessive installation effort was needed. Initially, we heard that rear door panels were suspects. Then more information came and identified the left-hand door panels only. And then model A was the parts that we had the problem or they experienced a problem, and then we found out that within model A, all colors and all options were suspect, and the doghouse, the section that I explained in the beginning, were deformed, and as a result, they would require excessive force for installation. And since this is labeled as S rank, S for safety, it was urgent and very important for us to get on it and fix it scientifically so it will not recur. And normally, if it's not S rank, then the sensitivity is lower as far as fixing it immediately, and Band-Aid would work or could work. For S rank, for safety, you need to fix it rather immediately because the customer's team members or the final customer and user may be safety may be jeopardized. A little background about the problem. On the left-hand side, you see the photo of the door panel. And that's a section on the back that the doghouse is. And if you see a good picture of a doghouse, is that this leg over here is not deformed. And this is a place that the retainer is assembled. And retainer will keep the door panel affixed to the sheet metal. And you see in the second part, the red part, you see the deformed doghouse doesn't allow the door panel and the sheet metal to meet, to line up. So more aligning and more efforts and more force are necessary when assembling.